Shalom. Hey, we are the Hebrew Israelites. Come out week in, week out, prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom of America, man. First and foremost, we're going to give all praises to the Heavenly Father, the Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak, Kadash, man. Double honors to the apostles, the elders, the GMS, Ruel, peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. I'm out here, man, a little earlier today than I normally come out because we're supposed to get some rain starting around 4 o'clock. The rain gonna be heavy all weekend, 100% chance for the rest of the weekend, man. So I decided to come out a little early, try to get it in because it's showering right now. Just light shower right now, so later on it's gonna be heavy. So I decided I want to come in, and then I'm a little bit further down than when I normally be. I normally be about 20 feet that way, but they got stuff set up where I have camp at. Got all kind of stuff set up because they doing something in this building. They got like a generator right here that's making noise. If you can probably hear it in the background. So they set stuff up where I normally have my camp, which is a little bit further down. But hey, I just moved down a little bit. We ain't gonna worry about it. The word gonna go out. So, yeah, we out to prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom of America, man. AKA Babylon, AKA Egypt, man. Sodom. Because Sodom is, it's like wicked Sodom, the spiritual known as Sodom, man. Let me read that. Revelations, Revelations 11 and 8. And it says, and their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city. Their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, man. That great city being what? America, man. America's that great city that's spoken of when you read in Revelation 17. When you read in Revelation 11, where I'm reading now. It's that great city, man. It says, and their dead bodies shall lie in the street of that great city. Whose dead bodies? The nation of Israel, right? Two-thirds of our people. Their dead bodies, meaning what? They're spiritually dead, man. Two-thirds of these people. Two-thirds of our people, they have no righteousness in their blood at this particular eon. Now, when they're destroyed and they come back in the kingdom of heaven, then they'll have that righteousness back. But as of now, they don't have that righteousness, man. Two-thirds of our own people, they're spiritually dead here in America, man. And it says, and their dead bodies shall lie in the street of that great city, which is spiritually called Sodom in Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified, man. In the true image of Yahweh Shai, that's what was crucified in America. They exed out. According to the scriptures, that would be according to the Bible, this is the true image of how the Lord looks, man. According to Revelations, man, first chapter, right? But his whole image was exed out and whitewashed out here in America. It was basically exed out in America by iconoclasm, right? This is when it was X'd out, when in the Renaissance period. And this is the image that they put up. That's the image that they put up as being our savior, man. You know? Jose Christos is negro, no blanco, right? And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom in Egypt, man, because America takes on all the ancient customs, man, of ancient Egypt, right? And then in Sodom, what happened in Sodom? A lot of people in Sodom were Sodomites, man. Today you call them homosexuals, man. And they're basically running everywhere, man. And the Spirit had me reading because right when I set up, it was bringing in the camp. You had two of them walk by posing as women, man. And that's running rampant in this place, man. That's a filthy abomination, man. Two men lying together, that's an abomination. And that's going to be taken care of when the Lord comes back. Let me tell you, let me show you. That's the chapter of Leviticus 20.
Hey, at least I thought about that.
Leviticus 20 and 13. If a man also lie with mankind as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death, and their blood shall be upon them, man. So it says, if a man lie with a man like you lie with a woman, right? How you lie with a woman? You lie down with a woman, you insert your rod into her vagina, and you have relations, right? Which bring forth children. You bring forth your generation, right? Two men, the Lord know what he was doing, man. When he say he didn't want two men to lie down, he know. How can two men and two women reproduce? He said be fruitful and multiply, man. He didn't say be fruitful and multiply and be fucking sodomites or homosexuals. He didn't say multiply and be those. He said, hey, man be with woman and y'all and be fruitful and multiply. Bring forth the generation, man. You know? What it says. If a man also lie with mankind as he lied with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. Abomination is a filthy, evil act, man. A disgusting, unethical act. And these men, the scripture tells you here in Deuteronomy 22. Deuteronomy 22 and 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all that do are an abomination. Right? That's the testimony. It says, unto the Lord thy power. So you're detestable. You're defiled and detestable unto Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, man. If a man wear women's garments, man. Those were two men that walked by here when the camp started, man. You know, got on fucking halter tops and they be wearing bras and fucking panties and shit. You know, wearing makeup, wearing a weave in their head, man. And these women wear what pertaining to a man, man. These women don't supposed to be wearing fucking jeans and shit, man. With zippers, man. Men wear pants, man. You're supposed to be wearing dresses. You're supposed to have your head covered up according to the scriptures, man. This is the law and the statute that the Lord put forth. You know? But our people don't want to obey the laws and the statutes that Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai has put forth. Therefore, death is going to come to them, man. It's sickening, man, when you see two men or two women going together, man. That's the end of that, man. Ain't no reproduction coming out of that, man. And then they give them talking about you got a right to adopt a kid, man. How you gonna adopt? What you gonna adopt, man? Two women together, being lesbians, and you gonna adopt a girl, right? And raise her up like that from a baby. That's all she gonna know is two women gonna be together. What you think she gonna learn? She gonna see that. And when she get old, she gonna do the same thing, man. You got two men together, you gonna adopt a boy, and he see you and the next man kissing constantly. And he gonna do the same thing, man. That's why a man be with a woman. So when you have women, children, and men children, they can grow up and see the right order on what it's supposed to be, man. You know? You growing up, you see your father going to work. You know? You see him come home, you see how he act. You see how he move. He'll teach you how to become a man, and a woman teach her daughter how to become a helpmate to her husband, man. And that's a detestable thing to see two men together and two women, man. You know? in the scriptures, man. Book of Judges, 19th chapter. It says, and the old man said, peace be with thee. However, let all they want lie unto me, only lodge not in the streets. So they brought him unto his house and gave provender unto the ass man. They gave fodder to the ass man, they gave grass to the horse. And it says, and they washed their feet and did eat and drink. Now as they were making their hearts merry, behold, the man of the city, certain men, sons of Belial, beset the house round about and beat at the door and spake to the master of the house. And the old man saying, bring forth the men that came into thine house that we may know him, right? So they were saying, the men of Belial was saying, bring forth these men that you have in your house that we may know them. They will want to know them carnally, man. Let me pull up my phone. See, can I pull that up? They will want to know them carnally, man. Just like when you read in Leviticus, the 19th chapter, when Lot had the angels stay with him, the men of Sodom wanted to actually beat down the door for him to have sex with the angels, man. This is wicked, man. This reverse spirit has always been there, man. Let me look up Judges. See if they... 19:22. It says, Yadah means to know them. Now, hey. Now you go to that definition, it's plenty of definition, right? Go and say to know or to learn, right? So they didn't really want to go and talk to him and say, hey, how you doing? Where you from? Y'all from Galilee? Yeah, what going on? They don't want to know him like that. The definition that goes with that particular scripture was the one right here in number three definition, which is to know a person carnally. Carnally, that's what goes with that scripture, right? It says to know them carnally. So what they wanted to do, they wanted to actually sleep with those men, man. When it said we want to know them, they were beating down the door to know those men. That particular number three, it says to know a person carnally. So when you read that Judges 19:22. It says, now as they were making their hearts merry, behold, the men of the city, certain sons of Belial, man, right? It says, certain sons of Belial, and it's got a number right there. By the sons of Belial, it's a number two, the number two, right? And in my margin, it says, for the number two on verse 22, it says, perverted men. Right?
Yeah.
Perverted men, man. Now, let's look up that word. It says that those men wanted to know them, and in the margin it says they were perverted men, man. So I'm going to look that word up so you'll know what it means. Okay? Middle English, French, pervertir,
pervertere, Latin, pervertere, corrupt, perverted, right? Distorted, synonym for it, right? Twisted, warped, misled. Number two is another definition for the word pervert. The second definition, a person whose sexual behavior is considered not normal or acceptable. So what's not acceptable? What's not acceptable is what the scripture said in Leviticus 20:13. What's not acceptable is two men lying together, man. Or two women lying together. That's what's not acceptable. It says, one given to some sexual perversion. What's not acceptable? Hey, what's not acceptable is two, like I said, two men or two women lying together. That's not, that's immorally wrong, man. That's what was going on here, right? It says, and the man of the master of the house went out unto them and said unto them, nay, my brother, nay, I pray you, do not so wickedly. So the man was praying unto the maid, man, don't do that, man. That ain't right, you know? Y'all trying to lay with these men, you trying to lay with these men sexually, man. That ain't right. And it says, I pray you, do not so wickedly. Seeing this, that this man has come into my house, do not this folly, man. It says, do not this folly, you know? Don't commit a basically, you commit an outrage when you're trying to lay with this man. He's a guest in my house, man, you know? And it says, behold, here is my daughter, a maiden, and his concubine. Them I will bring out now, and humble ye them, and do with them what seems good unto you. But unto this man, do not so a vile thing. That vile meaning corrupt, right? It means corrupt. Undesirable, unpleasurable. I'm gonna look it up. He said, he told him, do not this vile thing. Let me go back to that particular scripture. Judges 19:23 says, do not this vile thing. Vile in the Hebrew, Nabala, meaning senselessness, folly, disgraceful folly, immorally, profane action. And profane coming from profanus, and profanus meaning outside, unholy and outside the temple, man. And we know the temple to be what? Israel, man. Right? So it's unholy, and Israel were given what? The law, statutes, and commandments. And it is a law, it's a statute, and it's a commandment for two men not to be together. So if you see two men together, or men wanting to be with men, that is unholy, man. And that's outside the temple, man. It says the word vile. Disgrace. Foolishness, wickedness, crime. It is a crime against what? The law. If you go against the law, sets and commandments, you basically committed a crime. I think that's what Esau was calling. You go against their laws they set up in this system of Babylon. They call it a crime. So when you go against the law, sets and commandments, you committed a crime, man. So if you are into that, men laying with men, that is a crime against the Lord, man. You know, that's a vile crime against Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, man. A crime punishable unto death, right? That's a crime that's gonna bring death, man, you know? Uh, back in Judges 19. I read 24 again. It says, behold, here is my daughter, a maiden, his concubine, to them. It says, I will bring them out and humble ye them and do with them unto this man. Do not such a vile thing. So don't do this immoral act. Don't be an outrage. Don't do no this senseless wickedness act and trying to like lay with this man carnally. But we read the definition. The definition goes with that scripture's number 3. Which is, they don't want to just know him and know, hey, who's your father and where you come from and how is to be living in Galilee or Nazareth or wherever you're from. They don't want to know, you know, nothing like that. Like, because they were in Bethlehem, it says in the beginning. They were passing through Bethlehem, Judah. Right? They didn't want to know, are you from Gibeah? They didn't want to know, you know, what do y'all do? Like most people when we talk, what is it to do when you're there and all this? They wanted to know them carnally, man. They wanted to have sex in their anus, man. You know? Which is a filthy crime and an abominable act. You know? Just like when you read in Leviticus. Right? 19th chapter, man. And the spirit had me go over it, because as soon as I started, man, you had Jake now, man. Jake done walked by.